that there are suspicions. There was a huge security operation in Lurgan on that particular evening because of hoax bombs. The question that people are asking is, how come with such a heavy security presence that someone could go into what is a very nationalist area, plant a bomb and get out again, and have the audacity to do it at a time when there was a heavy security presence?
Nelson complained she was being harassed by police officers. Later, she told the Committee on the Administration of Justice the harassment had become threatening.
She began to receive threats via her clients who were in police detention. So when clients of hers would be arrested and brought to Gough Barracks or Castlereagh, they would then report back to Rosemary that police officers were making derogatory comments about her or else making death threats against her.
What kind of derogatory comments?
Well, there would be comments about her personal appearance, there would be comments about her professional integrity, there would be allegations that she was involved in paramilitary activity, and she found those comments particularly hurtful.
Public profile on the Colin Duffy case and her later work with the Gravachie Road residents made her a figure of hate among some loyalists. Since the murder of solicitor Pat Finucane 10 years ago, justice campaigners have been concerned by the lack of distinction between them and their clients in the minds of loyalist killers. But they say it's not a problem confined to loyalists.
The type of activity which has gone unchecked over the last 10 years, the type of activity which has allowed police officers to issue threats and issue derogatory comments against lawyers has really created the context within which lawyers like Rosemary were targeted.
Why would anyone want to take away the life of a lady who did so much good for her family and her community? Our community has lost a tireless worker for human rights.
It did not matter if she was being a mother, wife, daughter, sister or solicitor. She always cared for us, and that is the way we remember her.
Nearby said there'd been a large security presence in the area and questioned how the bomb could have been planted, but it seems to have been attached to the vehicle whilst Mrs. Nelson was away on holiday. The London solicitor Gareth Pearce, who's also represented Irish Republicans, was a friend of Rosemary Nelson's over many years.
There are absolutely fundamental international norms that are meant to apply to defence lawyers, and whoever defence lawyers defend, they should not be equated with causes if they're unpopular causes, and she ought to have been protected. It would have been known that she was at risk.
Rosemary Nelson was in the process of prosecuting the police over the murder of Robert Hamill, who was kicked to death by loyalists in Portadown. Only last week this programme talked to her about that murder.
The investigation was wholly inadequate. The family was treated with something less than courtesy.
As it turned out, this was probably the last television interview this high-profile solicitor ever gave. Her usually busy office in Lurgan's High Street, well known to journalists from around the world, is now shut up.